sending us, the role of Holy Spirit in sending us. The title I am giving to the message based on Isaiah chapter 55. If you have your Bibles, please open with me to Isaiah chapter 55. Invited to become God's invitation letter. Invited to become God's invitation letter. Now, the whole process, I can show it in a kind of a story. This story, I'm copying it from a small video clipping I bumped into YouTube. And in one of Ravi Zacharias' messages, I heard he's giving the same kind of story. I don't know whether he also bumped into the same YouTube story or something else. The story goes like this. There was a guy who was having a Google map in his hands, and he wants to go to a certain place, and as per the map he has to take a route, but there is a route which is shorter. When he was about to take the turn, there was a warning there: don't take this route because it is very dangerous. But still he takes that route. For 90 kilometers it's a desert, so he goes in the desert, and once he crosses about 70 or 75, the gas is over and the vehicle stops, and he doesn't know where to go. It's in the middle of a desert. So he walks from there. As he was walking, probably he walks about 10 or 15 kilometers, he comes across a abandoned village like scene. So he rushes there, and there he finds a pump, because he was very much thirsty. So he uses that pump to draw the water. The water never comes. He was so tired and he's almost exhausted. He's getting dehydrated. So he almost collapses and he sits there. When he was sitting there, there is a kind of a placard that is tied to the pump, and it says there is water in a bottle under that rock. What you have to do is this: you take the bottle of water, pour into this and pump, and the water comes. Before you start drinking, what you have to do is fill the bottle and keep it back under that rock, because people who come after you, they can use the pump. So this fellow lifts the rock and he finds the bottle. The moment he finds the bottle, he takes it, and he's so thirsty, he's tempted to drink the water from the bottle. When he was about to drink the water, the conscience says, no, don't drink, pour this water into the pump and you'll get as much water as you can. You can drink the water, fill the bottle and keep it back for the people to come back and drink. But he doesn't listen to his conscience. He finishes the bottle. Once the bottle is over, he has no more water. And after a few steps, he falls down and he dies. It is not only his death, it's the death of several people who are supposed to come on that path. Had he drunk the water, after pouring the water into the pump, he would have survived and he would have left a legacy behind. But he did not obey. He died, and his death resulted in the death of several people. My friends, what am I communicating through this? God made you with a purpose, and the purpose is that you should obey him, and when you obey him, you are going to become a channel of blessing to several people. Is that not the motive we see in the scripture in several occasions? God calls Abraham and says, if you obey me, I'll make you a blessing to several people. And Abraham obeyed. 4,000 years, still we are experiencing his blessings. Now think about Samaritan woman. She obeyed Jesus Christ. She believed Jesus Christ. She became a blessing to the whole village. My friends, you have come here to hear the word of God. And if you obey the word of God, my friends, this is the promise I give, not based on what I know, but based on what I've experienced from the scriptures, you will become a blessing. But let me tell you the flip side of it. If you don't obey, it will be a curse unto you. Probably it's been a long time you heard the word curse. Probably you don't hear that word here in USA. People can be sued if they use the word curse. But by the name of God, the authority that God has given to me, I'm speaking this word out. If you don't obey, you are doomed to hell. And you are becoming cause to lead so many people into hell. And the word of God is so powerful, my friends. Would you like to obey and be a blessing, or if you want to disobey and become a curse? The choice is yours. And that's what we are going to look into in this passage. Isaiah chapter 55. I gave you a story which tells what Isaiah 55 says. And then I gave an outline which again tells what Isaiah 55 says. And now we are going into the exposition of the whole chapter. It's a very small chapter, 13 verses, but still you can enjoy it because it has all the three levels what we are supposed to have. Level 1 is found in verse 1 and 6 and 7. What is level 1? It is an invitation. God calling us. You have come to the holy convocation because you have been invited. God has two levels of invitations according to Osgenes. Osgenes wrote a book called The Call. And in that, he says God's call always comes in two levels. He gives a very familiar example to make us understand what are these two calls. It is something like this. Imagine you have a son. Just imagine you have a son. And your son went out to play in the playground. Your son is playing with about half a dozen kids. When you go out and you call in a typical way, Babu, who will respond among those seven people who are playing outside? Only your son, not the other six. You're calling Babu, that's all. You are not calling Raju, you are not calling Ravi, you are not calling Naveen, you are calling Babu. But still, it's only your son who will respond. Why? Because he's already related to you. Call one is for relation, call two is for obedience. You got my point, my friends? Probably you are all related to God. But still, I want to give you this call. Are you obeying God? That's the beauty of it. We need that call again and again. Now let us look in some of the characters where we have these two levels of calls. Think about Peter. Peter was called by Jesus Christ. And for 3.5 years, Peter was with Jesus Christ. There is a kind of a relation between Peter and Jesus Christ. At one moment, Peter says, I will not allow that to happen. I will come between you and the enemies. Ninnu chavaninu, neenanna chastan gani. Ani adduga vachinunchunnadu Peter. And that's relationship. But the same Peter need to be called again after the resurrection. And then he became the most powerful leader in the Christendom. My friends, we need a second call. Am I giving a new theology? No, my friends. Am I giving a pseudo thought? No, my friends. This is biblical. That's biblical. Abraham received two calls. He received call when he was on the other side of Euphrates. And when he received that call, he had a relation with God. He left his nation. He left his land. But he came out with his father. God asked actually to leave even his father. He did not leave his father. Then he did not leave his brother. The promise that God gave, God delayed because his obedience was half. When father died, when Lot was separated, when he was living a helpless life, at the age of 99, God comes back to him and says, hey, I'm going to bless you, man. And that's where God blessed him. And that's the second call he gets. We need a second call, my friends, here. And that's why we have come to this holy convocation. If you have the passion, if you have the call, and if you have the assurance that God is with you, my friends, what you're going to do, how you're going to do, doesn't matter. What you're going to do, how you're going to do, doesn't matter. If you know that you have been called by God, if you have the heartbeat of God, if you have the passion given by God, if you have the burden given by God, you are bound to excel for God. You're bound to live for God. You're bound to declare the glory of God. The invitation comes. Let's see what's the invitation all about. Verse 1. Come, all you who are thirsty. Come to the waters, and you who have no money. Come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Now, if you look at this verse, there are four comes. The word come comes four times. Come, all you are thirsty. Come to the waters. Come by, four times. One theologian, I was looking into several books, looking at this passage. One theologian said, probably God wanted to call on four directions, north, east, west, south. All the four possible directions. And he said, come on, come on, come on, come on. Everyone, the call is for everyone. There is no one who is left out. Let me tell you one thing. In God's creation, no human being is a worthless person. Why? Even if there is one worthless person, the creator becomes worthless. Only a worthless creator brings out a worthless creation. Only a useless creator brings out useless creation. Our Creator God is marvelous. Our Creator God's wisdom is you cannot even comprehend. It's so high. Ento goppa devudu mana devudu. Anto goppa devudu paniki malina vaanni tayaru cheyadu. If you have the feeling that I'm useless, if you have the feeling that I'm worthless, probably you can find your worth only in one place. Where? In the presence of God. In the presence of God. My friends, we always presume that we have worth in a different location, like prodigal son. Now, prodigal son was with the father. He thought he's worthless. Then he wanted to go away to find worth. And finally, when he went out, he understood the real worth without father. That is zero. The Bible says when he came to senses, he decided to come back to the father. When he came back to the father, he got the worth back. He got the worth back. My friends, you need to come. So today God is inviting us, come, come. And he says, you come to me. The word come here in the Old Testament, the Hebrew come, is something like the street vendor shouting. Road meda manaki ikkada Europe lo, US lo undadu gaani, India lo untadu kada. Atla ante karivabagu, chikkadakai, beerakai, vankai. That's it. Street wonder. You got my point? That's exactly what he's saying. There is a guy with a cart shouting. Arskunte eltha untadu. Have you ever, has this happened to you anytime? It won't happen in US, but definitely it happens in India. Etlaga telusa? Arustu untadu. Beerakai, chikkadakai, and arustu untadu. Arustu unte, you start thinking. Beerakai kavala, chikkadakai kavala, beerakai kavala, chikkadakai kavala. Aithe decide chesukune lopala, ellipothadu koorgayalodu. Have you ever thought like that? Now, this is the exact picture that comes there. Okay, aina arichinappudu ventane respond aithe kurgal dorukutai lekapothe dorakam inta kante evadu explain cheyaledu idi kuda explanation dorakapothe lift lo kelthe 9th floor lo kelthaaru akkadi nunchi dookeyandi. That's what I can say. It's very clear. You call and you when he calls, you respond to him when he's found. Aina doruku kalamlo vetakandi. Ardhamainda? Kurgayalu kottodu bayata unnappudu ariste vaadu samadhanam cheptadu. Vaadu lenappudu nuvvu ariste ninnu picchodu antaru. Ardhamainda neeku? Aina ellipoyina tarvata arustunavu nuvvu. If you try to scream, if you try to shout, if you try to respond, after that guy goes away, you are considered to be a fool. So very clearly the message comes to us. You respond when the call is given. We have so many examples that are given in the New Testament. We have the example of the banquet. You know that? There was an invitation that was given and they did not respond. Do you know what the manager says? You go into the streets and call. Whoever comes, you bring. Whoever comes, you bring. Now that is the situation we are in. God is calling. If you respond, he will immediately incorporate. If you don't respond, Satan will incorporate you by default. You got my point? When you buy a laptop or a computer and you have the Word software into it, you have the New Times Roman. You know that? That's called the default. By default, you are incorporated by Satan. That's all. But when the call is given, if you allow Jesus Christ to incorporate you into his team, my friends, that's better. Or else, by default, you go there. So the option is given to you. And who can come to him? And the call to is to whom? Come all who are thirsty. What is thirst? Thirst is a desire. If you have the desire, you can respond to him. If you don't have desire, you cannot respond. Now here, to satisfy thirst, what do we need? Water. Thirsty for water. Man is a dipsomaniac. What do you mean by dipsomaniac? Man cannot live without water. Okay? Man is dipsomaniac. He cannot live without water. The body cannot survive without water. In the same way, God, when he created our soul, he created with a necessity, and the necessity is the Holy Spirit. When you are not feeling that thirst, that means you are dying already. You're dying already. That is why Jesus Christ takes the example of thirst and he says, I'm going to give you water. When he says water, water is symbolized and it is shown as Holy Spirit. You know John chapter 7, in that festival, Jesus Christ stands in the one corner, raises his hands and he probably screams like this, Hey, evankaina dappiga avutunda rendra vai nandri nee neelista. That is what Jesus said. Jesus Christ degariki evarina vaste neellu etla istadaina glass lo posi istadu adi ayana ichchedi andaru neellu daavutunte emanadu telusa rei nu glass tho neellu daavutunavu emavutho telusa neellu kaduplo kelthe aa kadupu cheruvu avudra hey neeku ardhamainda nee nichcheti neellu taagite kadupu cheruvu avudi glass neellu neeku dappiga teeriste నువ్వు చెరువు అవుతావు. చెరువు అయితే ఏమవుతుందో తెలుసా? ఒక గ్రామం గప్పి దప్పిక తీరుస్తావు. దాట్ ఈస్ వాట్ గాడ్ సేస్. దాట్స్ మై లాజిక్. మనం ఒక్క బియ్యపు గింజ ఇస్తే ఒక్క బియ్యపు గింజ వస్తుందా? రాదు. ఒక్క బియ్యపు గింజ ఇస్తే గెలొస్తుంది. ఒక్క బియ్యపు గింజకి ఒక్క బియ్యపు గింజ వస్తే దునియాకి సరిపోతుంది రా భయ్. చాలదు. See the logic, my friends. And that's what God says. You are like a seed. If I sow, there will be a big tree. నీకు ఎన్ని రకాలైన ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాలా? చెట్టు ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాలా? నీళ్ళ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాలా? చేపల ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాలా? ఏం ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాలా? పందికి ఒకటే పిల్ల పడుతుందా? కాదు, మస్తు పుడతాయి. అర్థమైందా నీకు? విచ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యూ వాంట్? And that's the logic he is using. You come to me, I will satisfy your thirst so that you can satisfy the thirst of many people. Many people. That's the whole logic he is trying to give. So if you are thirsty, you are eligible to take the call. To whom is this call coming? Ippudu nenu endaka annanu kada second call ani akada yedugru pillalu ఆడుకుంటున్నారు. బాబు అంటే మన కొడుకు రెస్పాండ్ అవుతాడు. 10 కోళ్ళు ఉన్నాయి అక్కడే. బొబ్బో అంటే మన కోడి వస్తుంది కదా. అదే గొర్రెలు ఉన్నాయి, రురు అని అడిగితే మన గొర్రె వస్తుంది కదా. యేసు ప్రభు కూడా అదే అన్నాడు, నా గొర్రెలు నా స్వరం వింటాయి. అర్థమైంది కదా. ఇక్కడ కూడా దేవుడు అరుస్తున్నాడు, నువ్వు రెస్పాండ్ అయ్యావంటే అర్థమైంది తెలుసా, ఆయనకి నీకు లింక్ ఉందని అర్థం. రెస్పాండ్ కాలేదంటే అర్థమైంది తెలుసా, ఫోన్ స్విచ్ ఆఫ్ చేసుకున్నావు అని అర్థం, ఛార్జింగ్ లేదని అర్థం, కవరేజ్ ఏరియాలో లేదని అర్థం. అర్థమైందా, దానికి సాఫ్ట్వేర్ పోయిందని అర్థం, వైరస్ వచ్చిందని అర్థం, సిమ్ కార్డ్ లేదని అర్థం. ఇన్ని మాటలు చెప్తామంటే నేను చెప్తాం, యూ కెన్ సే ఎనీ వర్డ్, సంథింగ్ ఈజ్ మిస్సింగ్. బట్ ఇఫ్ యు హ్యావ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ యు ఆర్ బౌండ్ టు రిసీవ్ ద కాల్, అండ్ ద కాల్ ఈజ్ గివెన్ టు దోస్ హూ ఆర్ థర్స్టీ. థర్స్ట్ ఈజ్ ద ప్రూఫ్ దట్ యు హ్యావ్ ద స్పిరిట్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్. If you don't have the Spirit of God, you cannot respond to the call of God. That's the logic. That's purely the what we have to understand. I want to satisfy your thirst. I want to give you water. If you have this water, the thirst will be satisfied. People who have that thirst, who took the call, they lived for it, they died for it, they were on fire for it. I want to give you the example of this guy, you know, that speaks about thirst. CT Studd, he had two options. Option number one, to open the test match team for England. Okay, it's a dream desire, man, anybody's dream. What is that? The great dream is this: to be an opener for the English cricket team. And the other option is to take the bag and go to Asian continent to be as a missionary. What did he do? He left the gloves, he left the pads, he threw the bat, he took the Bible, took the bag, and went to India as a missionary. It's all the thirst. It's the thirst. When you have the thirst, you can leave anything. Because you know what you have to hold. ఏది పట్టుకోవాలో నీకు తెలుసు కాబట్టి ఏది వదిలేయాలో అది వదిలేస్తావు. When you know what you have to hold, you can confidently leave what you have to leave. That's where I'm coming to the concept of invitation from verse 6 and 7. Let's read verse 6 and 7. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way and the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, and for he will freely pardon. See, when God is calling, there are two things that you need to do. You need to leave something and you need to hold on to something. Holiness is also like that. You need to leave something and you need to hold on to something. But let me tell you one thing. ఒకడు చెట్టుకి వేలాడుతున్నాడు అండి, చెట్టుకి వేలాడుతున్నాడు, అర్థమవుతుంది, చెట్టుకి వేలాడుతున్నాడు. అది వదిలితే కనుక అడు చస్తాడు. వాడిని వదలమని చెప్పడానికి నువ్వు ఏం చేయాలి? ముందు వాడికి ఇంకో కొమ్మ చూపించాలా? అరే ఈ కొమ్మ గట్టిదిరా, దాన్ని వదిలేరా అంటే అప్పుడు దీన్ని వదిలి దాన్ని పట్టుకుంటాడు. దాన్ని వదిలేరా అంటే అడేమంటాడు, వదిలితే దేన్ని పట్టుకోవాలి నేను? ఇఫ్ యు నో వాట్ యు హ్యావ్ టు హోల్డ్, you can confidently leave what you should not hold. That's why Jesus said, come to me, hold on to me. Nannu pattukora bhai, nannu pattuko. Nu edu odileyalante odiledirichu. If you are able to hold me, you can leave the whole world. But if you are not holding me, duniya mottam pattukunna inkemana kavalanipistadi. Duniya mottam pattukunna, the whole world may be in your pocket, but still you'll be craving for something. Still you'll be dissatisfied. Still you want more. A dil mange more. That's what. You'll never be satisfied. Because manalni satisfy cheyagaligedi okate mana dilni devudu. Kabatti devudu annadu tesa, come to me when I am found. Nenu dorikinappudu naa deggiriki raan. Now, leaving and holding. Deentlo manaku kanabadedi enti telusa? Leaving ki manam upayogiche padam entante repentance. Oddili pettadanni repent antam. Pattukodane untam faith an antam. Repentance, faith rendu undali. Chaala mandi ikkada kurchunna vallaki repentance untadi, కానీ ఫెయిత్ ఉండదు. హౌ డు ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దట్? రిపెంటెన్స్ అంటే అన్నా నేను సినిమాలు చూడనే, అన్నా నేను దరిద్రమైన పనులు చేయనే, నేను చర్చికి వస్తా, నేను అది చేస్తా, ఇది చేస్తా, ఇది రిపెంటెన్స్. ఏదైతే చేయకూడదో అది చేయకుండా ఉన్నావు, అయిపోయిందా? అక్కడికి గడ్డి తినటం మానేశావు, అన్నం తినాలా? లేకపోతే ఏమంటే తెలుసు, కనీసం ఆ గడ్డి అన్న తినరాబోయ్ అంటాను నేను. నువ్వు గడ్డి మానేసి అన్నం కూడా మానేస్తే సస్తావు, అర్థమైందా? ఇఫ్ యు లీవ్ దిస్ యు హోల్డ్ ఆన్ టు సంథింగ్. దీన్ని విడిచిపెట్టి మధ్యలో ఉంటే ఎట్లాగా? అందుకే ఇట్లాంటి వాడిని వేసి ఏమన్నాడు తెలుసా, అది నువ్వు అటు లేవు ఇటు లేవు మధ్యలో ఉన్నావు, నాకు గలీజ్ అనిపిస్తుంది నిన్ను చూస్తే. నువ్వు అటన్న ఉండు ఇటన్న ఉండు, అయితే గడ్డి అన్న తిను అన్నం అన్న తిను, ఏమి తినకుండా ఉంటే సస్తావురా నువ్వు, సస్తావు. జూడాస్ ఇస్కరియోతు చచ్చిండు, ఎందుకో తెలుసా? ఆడికి రిపెంటెన్స్ ఉంది కానీ ఏమి లేదు, ఆడికి ఫెయిత్ లేదు. అర్థమైందా నీకు? మస్తు ఏడ్చిండు ఆయన, ఏడవలేదా? చాలా ఏడ్చిండు, ఆయన అనవసరంగా చంపేసిండ్రా నేనే అని మస్తు ఏడ్చాడు. ఏడ్చేమి లాభం? ఊరేసుకొని చచ్చిండు, కూతు ఖుషి. అర్థమైందా నీకు? కుదు ఖుషీ చేసుకోవద్దు, ఖుషీ చేసుకో. ఖుషీ ఈజ్ ఇన్ జీసస్, కుదు ఖుషీ ఈజ్ ఇన్ యూ. ఇట్స్ అప్ టు యూ మై ఫ్రెండ్స్, యూ డిసైడ్. సో జీసస్ హియర్, గాడ్ సేస్ కమ్, ఐ విల్ సాటిస్ఫై యువర్ థర్స్ట్ వెరీ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ఇన్విటేషన్. వన్స్ ద ఇన్విటేషన్ ఈజ్ యాక్సెప్టెడ్ నౌ వీ గో టు. The moment you accept the invitation, what happens? You receive something. When you receive something, you go into a second level that is called celebration. Let's look at verse 2. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen to me, and eat what is good, and your soul will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me, hear me, that your soul may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promise to David. See, I have made him a witness to these peoples, a leader and commander of the peoples. See, if you come to me, I will make your soul happy, I'll make your heart happy, I will make your life happy, I will make your future happy. Everything is happy, 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 happy. Celebration. If you receive the invitation, if you respond to the invitation, it leads to celebration. Now here, I want to give you another beautiful Christian logic. Many of us don't have. What is the logic? If you are justified, you have to naturally move to the second level called sanctification. నువ్వు దేవుని చేత రక్షింపబడినట్లయితే, ఆ రక్షింపబడినటువంటి వ్యక్తి పవిత్రంగా జీవించటం అనేటువంటి సెకండ్ స్టేజ్లోకి వెళ్ళాలి. వెళ్ళలేదంటే ఇది జరగలేదు అని అర్థం. అందుకని యేసుప్రభు ఏమన్నాడు తెలుసా, మారు మనసుకు తగిన ఫలాన్ని. See, if you are healthy, there must be a sign outside. There must be a sign. Just imagine, you went to your doctor, showing your baby, saying that my baby is throwing food out. So, what doctor says is this, give this pill and the baby will stop throwing out. And how do I know the baby is stop throwing out? You will know that the baby is stop throwing out because you are feeding. Ante kada? ఫీడింగ్ ఆపేసి తాగుతుంది అది, చస్తాడు. యు ఫీడ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ యువర్ ఫీడింగ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కమింగ్ అవుట్. దట్ ఈస్ ద ప్రూఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ హెల్దీ. దట్ ఈస్ ద ప్రూఫ్ దట్ ద పిల్ ఈస్ వర్కింగ్. హౌ డు ఐ నో దట్ ఐఎమ్ బీయింగ్ యాక్సెప్ట్ బై గాడ్? ఐ నో బికాస్ ఐఎమ్ గ్రోయింగ్. హౌ డు ఐ నో దట్ ఐఎమ్ గ్రోయింగ్? ఐఎమ్ హ్యావింగ్ హంగర్, ఐఎమ్ హ్యావింగ్ డిజైర్. And that is what the concept of celebration is. What is he giving us in the level of celebration? He says, listen to me and eat what is good, and your soul will delight in the richest of air. Give ear and come to me. Hear me that your soul may live. I'll make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promise to David. See, I have made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander. Here, to make us celebrate and enjoy, God wants to give us four things. You can read that in verse 1. Come all you who are thirsty, come to the waters, you who have no money. Come buy and eat, come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. God wants to give us water. God wants to give us milk. God wants to give us bread. God wants to give us wine. What do you understand? Water and milk, they speak of, water speaks about the Holy Spirit. Milk speaks about the Word of God. Bread speaks about the presence of Jesus Christ. And wine speaks about the communion. And this actually makes us happy. If you're not able to understand this, I'm sorry. If you're spending your money, if you're spending your time to find happiness outside these four, you are a fool. I'm sorry to use that word. I have to use that word. You are a fool. Because it is found only in these four. Only in this world. And God wants to give that. That happiness is what God gives. Is not what you have achieved. If it is what you have achieved, we don't need God. We can get it on our own. So this is the celebration He wants to give to us. This is the celebration mode into which we have to go. So if you are willing to respond to the invitation, you will be going to the second level called celebration. And when you are celebrating, will you be silent? No, you can never be silent. In the Kings, book of Kings, we have a scenario where there was a famine and there was beggars, and when beggar bumped into food, what he did? He ate the food, and has he kept quiet? No. He called other beggars and tell there is food there. One beggar telling another beggar where to find food is evangelism. Nuvu kuda aruku tinatodve. Ardhamainda? Nuvu peddemo turunkana gadem em gaadu. Ardhamainda? Javvanikaina sare aanandam ayani ivvalsinde. Deva ayyava ante istadu ayana. Nuvu adukkunnavu ichinadu. నువ్వేం చేయాలా? ఇంకో అడుక్కున్నావని చెప్పాలా? అర్థమైందా? నువ్వు ఇంకొకరికి ఎందుకు చెప్పట్లేదు తెలుసా? నువ్వు పెద్ద తురుంకానా ఫీల్ అయినావు, ఏదో సంపాదించినట్లు. నువ్వు సంపాదిస్తే వచ్చింది కాదు ఇది. యు హావెంట్ అచీవ్డ్ ఇట్, యు హావెంట్ వర్క్డ్ అవుట్ ఫర్ ఇట్. యు గాట్ ఇట్ గ్రేషియస్లీ. నో, ద వర్డ్స్ దట్ వీ ఫైండ్ ఇన్ వర్స్ 1 ఇస్ దిస్, బై వితౌట్ మనీ. Now, if you look at those two words, it looks contradictory, but they are not contradictory. You buy, but without money. When you buy, you own it. Am I right? When you buy, you own it. Am I right? So, you own it, but without paying money. That's what God says. You can graciously own it. It's yours. Aapka naam likh do. Tera naam likh dunga. Gurtu vachindira kontamandiki? నాకు తెలుసు, నాకు తెలుసు, ఇది బాగా క్లిక్ అవుద్ది. కీర్తనలు 23:1 అంటే ఏందన్నా అంటారు? అదేనా? తెరనామలుకుదు అంటే వచ్చింది క్లిక్, కానీ బయటికి ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ చేయరు, నాకు తెలుసు. సో గాడ్ సేస్, లిక్ రే యార్ తెరా, ఆప్క నామ్ లిక్ దో. యు రైట్ యువర్ నేమ్, ఇట్స్ యువర్స్. ఏ ఆప్కా హై, you own it. That's the meaning of the word buy. But do I need to pay anything? No, you take it. Pukatla disco. That's what he says. Pukatla gonuko. So that's the ownership. So you have that, you got it. When you got it, you can't keep quiet. You have to go and share it with others. William Carey, because he understood the grace of God, he understood the value of the gospel, this is how he responded one evening. Do you know, one evening, he received a letter from William Bentinck. And the letter from William Bentinck, because he and Rajaramo and Roy, they're working on a project. And as they were working on the project, they wrote a 64-page document and gave it to William Bentinck to prove, according to the Hindu scriptures, that sati is illegal. William Bentinck read all the 64 pages and was convinced, and he wanted to completely abolish sati. And he wrote that and sent it to William Carey. And William Carey has the letter in English from William Bentinck. And the moment he saw that, it came to him on a Saturday evening. The moment it came to him, on Sunday morning, he's supposed to preach in a church. Do you know what he did? He called his assistant and he said, "You better preach. I need to translate it into the Indian languages, because even if I delay a day, some people might be killed." He sat there. And the history says that night, that one page has been translated into 32 languages by one man. One man. 32 languages. Tinnaga oka language vastadara neeku? Okkati. English poorthiga maatladu. Pon Telugu maatladtava? Adi raadu. Hindi maatladtava? Adi raadu. You can't speak even one language completely. Em vastadi manaki? But this man, he learned 44 languages, decided to translate Bible into 40. And in one night, one page has been translated into 32 languages, and he sent it to people. Amazing. That's what his celebration is. When you knew you got it because God's grace has provided to you, you don't want to hold it. You want to share it. You want to share it. If you are trying to hold it, that means you are not owning it. Somebody said like this, unless and until you decide to give, it is not yours. The gospel has become yours only when you decide to give to others. Gospel is communicated. The word communicated has the three word letters common, C-O-M. Do you know what is the meaning of that word common? What I have, you are now going to have. We share. It is neither yours nor mine. It is ours. That is the good news. That's the gospel. And that's what we are called to communicate. When you are in the celebration mode, you want to share it. You want to communicate it. So now, after that, we go to the third level. And what is the third level? Level one is invitation. Level two is celebration. Level three is declaration. Level one is invitation. Level two is ownership. Level three, you become the invitation card. What do you mean by invitation card? It is something like this. It's my family wanted to invite you. Sometimes what I can do is this. I can send my son to you, or I can send my daughter to you to invite you. So my son or daughter has become my invitation letter. Am I right? You and I should become God's invitation letter. I'm giving a contemporary term, but if I have to give the biblical version of this, he says, you are God's epistles. You got it? Your God's epistles. Probably you may not be able to understand what is an epistle, because we are in only SMS mode. Am I right? So we don't understand what is an epistle. When was the last time you went to a post office to drop a card or a letter? No. You don't do it. And that's why you can't understand that word epistle. Probably you have to communicate it in the contemporary language. You are God's invitation letter. You are God's Evite. You got it? I know you're laughing now. Somebody will say yes in your, what do you call, web page. How many S's are there for my Evite? That's what you have to look. How many yeah, how many nay? That's what I want. That's what God says. You are my Evite. I want to use you as that. So that's the declaration. Verse 5 goes for the declaration. Surely you will summon nations you know not, and nations that do not know you will hasten to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel. For he has endowed you with splendor. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. I'm reading verse 8. As the heavens are higher than the earth, are so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it, you will go out in joy and be led forth in the peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song before you, and all the trees of the field will clap their hands. Instead of the thorn bush will give the pine tree, and instead of briars the myrtle will grow. This will be for the Lord's renown, for an everlasting sign which will not be destroyed. Now if you look into the whole concept, what God says is this: I'm going to make you an invitation card. So what happens? When you are my invitation card, you're going to have a different splendor. You're going to have a different value. I can give you an example. It's an example that happened in my life. One night at about 11 o'clock, somebody was knocking my door in Bangalore. And it was raining. I opened the door. One guy was completely drenched in the rain. And he said in a typical Telugu, Anna, good evening, Anna. At 11 o'clock, if somebody knocks the door and says good evening, that is the biggest possible headache. Because that fellow will come inside, will not go home. And I need to somehow do something. That's the big, so many questions that were coming into my mind. I haven't recognized his face. And I said, okay, come inside with a lot of haste. And I said, what do you want? Who are you? And do you know what he did? Without opening his mouth, without saying anything, he opened up his bag and he showed a card. I looked at the card. And the card was having the name James Stephen, Principal, Welfare Engineering College, Vizag. At the back of the card, there are two words. Anna, this is my friend. Help. James Stephen is my friend, is my buddy. He sent me a card. The moment I saw the card and turned it, and the back of it said, Anna, take care of my friend. Do you know what I did? My total perspective changed. I started valuing that fellow. I gave value. I immediately gave him a towel. I woke my wife, prepared hot food, gave him food, made him to take rest, gave him the best facility. Do you know why? Why that fellow got the value? I don't know his name. I don't know his face. I gave him value because he's carrying a card. You and I, we are the card of God. We get the value. We get the splendor. See the word that's been used here. You are my splendor. You are the glory. You are my glory. And I'm sending you as my weapon. I'm sending you as my gadget. Surely you will summon nations you know not. And nations that do not know you will hasten to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy Lord, Holy One of Israel. For he has endowed you with splendor. He has endowed you with splendor. My friends, you have come to the convocation to be endowed by the splendor of God. And that should happen here. Hotel keltam biryani tintanki, cinema keltam chuttanki, mall keltam vastulu konukodaniki, convocation ki enduku vachinao telusa, devuni chetta splendor boni pondadaniki. Adi jaragakapothe convocation ku vachi waste nuvu. Waste. This should happen. This should happen. When you go out, you should go out with the splendor of God, with the glory of God. When you have received the glory from God, you will declare the glory of God. God can use you as a weapon when he has endowed you, when he has fueled you, when you have charged you. And that's what he says. And he says, when you are charged, no charge pondite ganaka ye ooru eltunnav ye desam keltunnav naaku assalu assalu ledu sambandham ledu nu ekkadiki poyina elugutavu ekkadiki poyina elugutavu. I want to ask you this question. You went to a shop to buy a pen. Got it? You want to buy a pen. Anybody who wants to buy a pen, what they do? They open the cap and they write. Right? Paper meda rasinappudu pen rayalana ledha? Rayalana ledha? Oka vela rayaledanko. Endra bhai rayaledante anna intiki vellin tarvata rasadante konukopothavu nu? Cheppu. Ari cheppra bhai. Ardham avutunda neeku? లేదన్న ఇక్కడ రాయదు ఇంటికి పోయిన తర్వాత రాస్తుంది నువ్వు ఇక్కడ ఎలగకపోతే బయట ఎలుగుతావు రావు నువ్వు ఎలగవు ఎలాగో యూ హ్యావ్ టు స్టార్ట్ గ్లోయింగ్ హియర్ ఇట్ షుడ్ హ్యాపన్ హియర్ యూ నీడ్ టు ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఇట్ హియర్ అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ నో విత్ వాట్ పర్పస్ యూ హ్యావ్ కమ్ దట్స్ వాట్ ఐ వాంట్ టు సీ వర్స్ 8-9 ఐ డోంట్ నో విత్ వాట్ పర్పస్ యూ హ్యావ్ కమ్ సౌలు ఉన్నాడే గాడిదలు పోయాయని వెళ్ళాడు ఏమయ్యాడైనా రాజయ్య కూర్చున్నాడు దావీదు అన్నవాళ్ళకి టిఫిన్ కట్టుకొని పోయాడు మురుకులు గిరుకులు పట్టుకొని పోయాడు అర్థమైందా అరే అన్నవాళ్ళు చాలా కాలమైందిరా జర పప్పాలు తీసుకుపో అన్నాడు మూట కట్టించిండ్రు పట్టుకుపోయాడు ఏమో గులి అతను చంపొచ్చాడు అర్థమైందా ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే ఐ డోంట్ నో వై యూ కేమ్ హియర్ మిగిలిన వాళ్ళకి అర్థం వచ్చినామో ఐ డోంట్ నో ది హిడెన్ అజెండా ఎవరికి తెలుసు బయటికి ప్రైజ్లు ఆడ పెట్టచ్చు అర్థమైందా మూడు రోజులు లాంగ్ వీకెండ్ ఏం చేయాలో అర్థం కావట్లేదు సార్ లేకపోతే అందరితో కలిసి కూర్చుందాం వంట కూడా ఉండాల్సిన పని ఉంటుంది దీన్ని పడుకోవచ్చు అని వచ్చేమో అరే స్ట్రైట్ మాట్లాడదాం దిల్సే లెట్స్ స్పీక్ స్ట్రైట్ ప్రాబబ్లీ యూ కేమ్ లైక్ దట్ నో ప్రాబ్లం నువ్వు ఎందుకు వచ్చినావు అని అడగట్లా వచ్చినావు కదా దేవుడు నీ మీద ఎలిగించి పంపిస్తాడు ఏమో దట్స్ అమేజింగ్ నో దట్స్ అమేజింగ్ దట్స్ వాట్ గాడ్ సేస్ అరే నా ధమాక్ నీ ధమాక్ లాంటిది కాదురా భయ్ అది ఆయన అనేది నీ ధమాక్ అలా చిన్నగా ఉంటుంది నా ధమాక్ పెద్దది మేరా ధమాక్ బోత్ బడా యార్ ఐ కెన్ ఇంక్లూడ్ ఎనీథింగ్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ షికాగో టు చింతపల్లి ఐ కెన్ ఇంక్లూడ్ ఎనీబడి అండ్ ఎనీవేర్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఐ కెన్ ఇంక్లూడ్ ద ఓన్లీ థింగ్ ఇస్ యూ నీడ్ టు రెస్పాండ్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు రెస్పాండ్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ మై గ్లోరీ అండ్ నౌ హీ యూజెస్ టూ మెటఫార్స్ హియర్ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ వాట్ ఆర్ ద టూ మెటఫార్స్ హీ యూజెస్ వన్ హీ యూజెస్ ఎ వెదర్ What is the weather he is trying to use? When the rain falls, what happens? It uses gravitation. Rain to hit the earth, it uses gravitation. A gravitation batti water pai nunchi kindaku vachi padtadi. Boom meda padindi. Padin tarvata aa boom ni tadupuddi. Tadipin tarvata chettlu gitla nostayi. అయిన తర్వాత ఏమవుద్ది ఇవాపరేషన్ స్టార్ట్ అవుద్ది ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ద ఆపోజిట్ ఆఫ్ గ్రావిటేషన్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ టు టేక్ బ్యాక్ ద వాటర్ ఇన్ టు ద క్లౌడ్స్ ఎమ్ రైట్ See the beauty of it. That's the process. Hydrological cycle. That's the process. So the process should begin in you. That's what he says. And the concept he uses is this. Rain ganaka kinda kochi yenkaki ela yeldo tadapakunda neenu maatladite ardhamainda neenu maatladite ninnu tadapakunda nenu ponu. Adi ayana adi. Aithe meeku oka beautiful analogy isthanu. షికాగోలో ఎప్పుడు పడితే అప్పుడు వర్షం వస్తుంది అవునా కదా వర్షం వస్తుంది వర్షంలో బయటికి వెళ్ళాల్సి వచ్చింది నీకు నువ్వు తడవకుండా ఉండాలంటే ఏం చేస్తావు చెప్పండి నాకు గొడుగు పట్టుకెళ్తావు అంతే కదా గొడుగుంటే మొత్తం అంతా తడుస్తుంది నువ్వు తడుస్తావా చెప్పు నాకు వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రెయినింగ్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ హోల్డింగ్ అన్ అంబ్రెల్లా ఎవ్రీ అదర్ పార్ట్ విల్ బీ వెట్ విల్ యూ బీ వెట్ ఈరోజు ఇప్పుడు అంబ్రెల్లా వేసుకొని కూర్చున్నావేమో ఇక్కడ నువ్వు హలో అర్థమైంది నీకు అంబ్రిల్లా వేసుకొని కూర్చున్నామో నేనా ఇంత చెప్పినా దేవుడు దాన్ని అంబ్రిల్లా అంటారు ఈడేం లాంగ్వేజ్ ఉపయోగిస్తున్నాడు ఇది మంచి లాంగ్వేజ్ ఉపయోగించట్లా అదొక అంబ్రిల్లా ఇది కోట్ వేసుకోవాలా ఇదొక అంబ్రిల్లా ఇడికి ఇంగ్లీష్ మంచికి రాదు ఇదొక అంబ్రిల్లా ఇది తెలంగాణ మాట్లాడుతున్నాడు అదొక అంబ్రిల్లా అరే గొడుగులు ముడిచిపోయి నువ్వు గొడుగు ముడిచిపెడితే దేవుడు తడుపుతాడు దట్స్ వాట్ ఈ సేస్ మనం ఎంత అజీబ్ అంటే అరే నేను వర్షం పంపిస్తే భూమిని తడుపుతా అంటే నేను గొప్ప నీ గొడిగేస్తానుగా దట్స్ వాట్ వీ ట్రై టు డూ వెన్ ద వర్డ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ ఈస్ బీన్ డిక్లేర్డ్ వాట్ గాడ్ సేస్ ఇస్ ఇట్ కెన్నాట్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ వితౌట్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్స్ వర్క్ అండ్ ద వర్డ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ ఈస్ బీన్ డిక్లేర్డ్ హియర్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫాలింగ్ ఆన్ యువర్ హార్ట్ If it is falling on your heart, it is bound to bear fruit. But if you are not allowing it to fall it on your heart, I'm sorry. You are another Judas. Why I'm using the word Judas? Judas was with Jesus Christ for 3.5 years. Manavadu 3.5 samvatsaralu godugu tagilichukunnadu. Anduke vaadu gunde tadavaledu. Chachindadu. You might be in the chosen group, but if you are using an umbrella, it won't touch you, my friends. So God says, I want to touch your heart and my word is that powerful. It will not change. It will be always powerful. The word of God, the spirit of God, when they both work on the person chosen by God, he will become the ambassador for God. That's the whole logic, my friends. And God has brought you here for that process to ignite here, to start here. And if God is speaking to you, would you like to respond and say, Lord, here I am, send me. Am I asking you to go into a full-time ministry? Who knows? God might be calling some people who came all the way from India to US to make him a missionary here and send him back. That's what happened to Jiva. We have a live example here. He came all the way here. Enduku ikkada missionary em chesi pampichindi aina devudu ajeeb untadandi bhai ajeeb untadu etla telusa joseph ni jail lo train chesadu palace lo vaadadu. He was trained in the prison, used in the palace. Moses was trained in the palace to be used in the wilderness. Am I right? దేవుడు నిన్ను షికాగోకి తీసుకొచ్చి ట్రైన్ చేసి ఇండియాలో వాడతాడేమో మిమ్మల్ని తెలుసు. హూ నోస్? గాడ్స్ వేస్ ఆర్ యునిక్. గాడ్ ట్రైన్స్ అస్ టు బి యూస్డ్ బై హిమ్. బట్ అల్టిమేట్లీ ఆఫ్టర్ గాడ్స్ ట్రైనింగ్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ గివెన్ టు అస్, వెన్ గాడ్ హ్యాస్ గివెన్ ఇనఫ్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్, వాట్ ఆల్ హీ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్స్ ఫైనలీ ఇస్ దిస్, విల్ యూ రెస్పాండ్ టు మై కాల్? నా యొక్క పిలుపుని అంగీకరిస్తావా? When he says, respond to my call, whatever profession you are in, if you are obeying him, my friends, God can take you to the next level. Cricket lo bowling cheyalante nu first 11 members lo okaniga undali, ante kada? Am I right? Nu 11 members lo okaniga unte bowling istharu, extra player ki bowling istadu ekkada? Cheppu naaku, nu extra gan laagu unnavu. Be in the team. గల్లీలో ఉండమంటాడా, కవర్స్లో ఉండమంటాడా, వికెట్ కీపింగ్ చేయమంటాడు, ఎక్కడో చెయ్యి, ఏదో ఒక టైంలో బాల్ ఇచ్చి బౌలింగ్ చేయమంటాడు. నువ్వు బయట ఉంటే ఎట్లాగా? ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఇన్సైడ్, వన్ డే గాడ్ విల్ గివ్ యూ ద బాల్. ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఇన్సైడ్, మోసెస్ వాజ్ ఇన్సైడ్, గాడ్ గేవ్ హిమ్ ద బాల్. జోసెఫ్ వాజ్ ఇన్సైడ్, గాడ్ గేవ్ హిమ్ ద బాల్. ఎస్థర్ వాజ్ ఇన్సైడ్, గాడ్ గేవ్ హిమ్ ద బాల్. దే ఆర్ ఆల్ నాట్ ఫుల్ టైమ్ వర్కర్స్. They are in secular position. Joseph is a finance minister. Esther is a Lady James Bond. Queen. David is king. Solomon is king. Nehemiah is the personal secretary to the king. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego are governors of each province. They are full-time secular workers. But they are in the ground. That's why God gave them the ball when it was needed. If you are in the ground, that means if you are available to the Lord, say the statement, here I am, use me when you want. Here I am, use me when I want. God can use you. God uses people in a great way in the secular position than in the so-called pastoral ministry. The moment you have the tag pastor, everybody will come with a mask. Praise the Lord, pastor. Ige em maatladtunnu nu? Aadu munde mask tagilichukoni vachindu. Nu kuda praise the Lord sister baunnara? Amma amma daddy baunnara? Prarthana chesi pampina ayipindi. Nothing has communicated. Nu atla gaakunda maamula officer em raavai manchukona mandu kodadama? Ippudu chusina there is a chance for communication when he is open. In the secular position, people will be more open than in the so-called created atmosphere. Church is a created atmosphere. If you bring people inside, they will have a mask. I'm not speaking against the church. Please try to understand. Church is for a different purpose. Here, church is to train people to go out. Here is the salt. It has to go out of the salt shaker. We need to go out. We need to be the light to the world, salt to the earth. Uppu uppu ke avana upaya padtada? Ardhamainda dialogue nadi? Uppu uppu ke avana use a mari deniki use? Kooraku use. Church ke upaya padadu, duniya ki use. Salt has to be useful to the society. Light has to be useful to the society. The church has to create the salt and send to the society. And you are that salt. And you are that light. Will you be willing to say, Lord, here I am. I want to go. I want to give you a couple of testimonies of people who wanted to be the salt, who responded to the call. Now, this is the first example. His name is Davis Scudder. He's a pastor. He's a doctor. And he's running a small clinic in Tamil Nadu. Okay? In a place called Villur. Okay? And one day, a Mrudalayar husband came. And he said, my wife is having pain and can you send your wife? He said, my wife is not a doctor. Can you send your daughter? He said, I can't send my daughter. I am the doctor. I can come. He said, you are a man. How can you check my wife? He did not allow Davis Scudder to check his wife, Mudaliar's wife. And that night, that wife died. A week later, there was another Muslim who came with the same question. And the same answer came. And that fellow, that lady also died. When these two deaths have taken place, Davis Scudder's daughter, Ida Scudder, she looked at it. She prayed. And she said, Lord, India needs a lady doctor. And she came all the way back here. She studied medicine, went back, and she started a clinic. And today, it is the renowned hospital in the whole of India, and it's called Christian Medical Center, CMC Vellore, started by a lady called Ida Scudder. She received the call. She responded. And just look at the amount of ministry this one lady could do. One lady could do. My friends, God can use your profession. God can use your talent. God can use your gift. Provided you give it to God. So this is as far as a career is concerned. Let me take another person. 1924. This is Paris Olympics. And this fellow came there to participate in 100 meters. And he's a believer. Every evening he used to meet a few other guys to pray. That Saturday evening he prayed and said, tomorrow if the 100 meter race is going to be during the church time, I'm not going to participate in it. And that's what he said. Exactly, the game was set on during the church time. He did not participate. Harold Abrahams participated instead of this guy. His name is Eric Little. Okay, instead of Eric Little, Harold Abraham participated in 100 meters. And Harold Abraham got gold medal. Everybody knew that Eric Little should get the gold medal. He's like Bolt. Sure of getting the 100 meters, but he did not participate. And his manager cursed him, used all bad words. Newspaper and media said that Eric Little has become religious fool. Those are the titles that have come. 2 days later, the manager comes to Eric Little and says, we have one slot free. Would you like to participate? And the slot is for the 400 meters relay. Do you know what Eric Little said? I never trained for it. I never tested it. I never did it. I will try to do it. He went there and stood. And when he was standing there, an old lady came to him with a piece of paper. He was not having even time to look at that paper. He tucked into his pocket. He ran, got the gold medal. When he received the gold medal, he put his hand into the pocket and found out the paper in which the old lady wrote one thing from 1 Samuel chapter 2. And the verse says, those who honor me, them I will honor. And Eric Little took the gold medal. And he made the statement, God gave me 2 strong feet to run faster. But he gave me a heart to go to China as a missionary. And he tucked the gold medal into the bag, went to China as a missionary. My friends, when God has made you for a purpose, if you don't fulfill that purpose, you are becoming a curse. You are becoming a curse. Finally, let me give this small illustration and conclude, my friends. There was a pastor who was preparing a message. It was a Saturday evening. He has a 6-year-old guy, and he said, Daddy, I want to pray with you. I want to play with you. He said, this is not the time I'm preparing. No, Daddy, God loves you, and you said that you always love me, so let's pray. Let's play. Then his dad doesn't know what to do. He found a world map there sitting on his table. He tore the world map into pieces and put them on a plate, and he said, now you saw the world map. You do one thing. Go, sit there. You stick all these papers, make the world map again, and come back. He's a six-year-old guy. What he thought was this. He can never make up the world map. But this pastor was preparing. Within 20 minutes, this guy came with the world map. He said, Daddy, the world map is ready. He looked at it and said, how could you do it? I said, where is easy? How could you do it, man? I don't know, Pop. It's very easy. I was looking at the papers. I found an I. And I knew there should be another I. I looked for the second I. Between these two eyes, there must be a nose. I looked for the nose. Under the nose, the mouth. And two ears, head, chest, hands, tummy, legs, feet, everything. I found a man standing like this. I stick the stickers and turned it, and the world map is set. On that day, Daddy got a beautiful answer. If you set right man, the world will be set right. The problem is not with the world. The problem is with us. If you are able to find your meaning in Christ, if you are able to set your place, your position, your status, your relation right, the whole world looks right. You can make it right. My friends, if God is calling you today, what would be your answer? I'm not asking you to leave your profession. I'm not asking you to leave your career. I'm only asking you one thing. Will you say like Isaiah, here I am, use me? Will you say that? If you're willing to say that, will you respond? You have come to the holy convocation to receive the splendor and to become the invitation card. If you have received the splendor, will you say, Lord, I am your invitation card. Use me. Where you want to send me, to whom you want to send me, it's yours. I'm here. Use me.